Numbers. When I was a student at this university many, many years ago, it had 4,000 students. Nowadays we have 40,000 students, and we have about 4,000 doctoral students and postdoctoral students. So out of those 4,000, very, very selected and good brains, I'm sure some of them will be competitive and also compete for ESC grants. So I'm confident, but I want to underscore that ERC should have excellence as its goal and select based on the very best proposals and do their best to find the best minds from wherever in Europe or outside of Europe, for that matter, they come.
You have been a significant part of the declaration. What is your hope for the future of the declaration?
My hope for the future, I'm very optimistic, in fact, because I think when I came back to Europe in 2005 from the United States, I saw that we had lack of optimism. I still feel a bit we lack optimism in Europe, but I also see light. I think we are getting more and more of the strong forces to formulate policies and also make the right selections and so forth. We have a lot of strength, and I see a bright future for Europe as one of the cornerstones of the global knowledge economy. So in that sense, I'm very optimistic. I'm also optimistic because a university like this one is a very young university, and we are doing, I believe, a good job for Europe, and many other universities can do the same. So I don't see why we shouldn't be optimistic and, in fact, also face the competition from the U.S. and China and other continental countries. Why be shy?